This month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly Magazine is all about food, but not just any food. The items featured are part of what they're calling their foodie bucket list. We decided to hit the streets to talk to some of you about your bucket lists. From food to fun, we covered it all.
Sail across the Pacific.
Maybe live abroad in Europe.
I guess travel to Asia.
So a lot of our interns here at the Rhode Show have it on their bucket list to actually do our job. So I'm going to let them. Michelle, Katzy, go for it.
Take my dad to the Masters.
Oh, I'd love to be on TV one day.
Oh my God.
Is there anything in Rhode Island that you'd like to try?
I want to go to Newport because I've never been and go to the beach.
I don't know. Maybe, no, Mount Everest is too aggressive. That's way too aggressive. I don't know, travel across, visit all 50 states in the U.S.
Yeah, that's on mine too. That's a good one.
I want to go to Argentina.
Awesome. And what do you want to do there?
Play soccer and learn about the culture.
I would travel around the world.
Probably like cliff jumping.
Get a nice car.
A lot of people always want to go skydiving.
I really want to go skydiving one day.
I want to go skydiving.
I haven't skydived yet.
Okay.
Yeah.
You want to give that a try?
Yeah, I'd like to be scared out of my mind.
Jump out of a plane. Gonna do that with my kids.
Go skydiving.
Hold on, what's it called? Jumping out of airplanes?
Skydiving?
Skydiving, thank you.
Something you want to do before you die?
Skydiving.
What's on yours?
I feel like I want to go to the Virgin Islands, lay on the beach, drink Mai Tais.
Take me with you.
I will.
Let's thank just you. Close our eyes. Let's pretend we're there.
Let's go. Where are we? Where are we?
Anywhere. Somewhere sunny.
All right.
With the Mai Tais, right?
Yes.
Okay. Just checking.
You. What about your Rhode Island bucket list? Do you have anything for Rhode Island that you would want to do?
To do in Rhode Island? Well, I'm actually going to go to RISD Museum today.
I'm new to Rhode Island, so I don't really know a whole lot about Rhode Island. Get to know Rhode Island.
Get a license. I don't know how to drive.
Wow. So if you could drive in Rhode Island, where would you drive to?
I'd probably go to Lincoln. Or no, not Lincoln. Jamestown. That's the one.
It's Purgatory Chasm in Rhode Island.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I've always wanted to go there and I've never been.
I want to go to the drawbridge that's like upright.
Oh, yeah.
Swing on top of the swing at the drawbridge. Like the
there's a swing up there?
Yeah, there's a swing all the way at the top.
I'd love to go just like hiking around in the area.
Definitely surfing. Surfing in Rhode Island.
I don't know. Go to all the beaches. Go sailing.
Oh, I'd love to eat lobster here.
Awesome.
Do you never have lobster here?
No.
Where are you from?
Columbus, Ohio.
I guess the Rhode Island bucket list is try some of the good seafood here.
What's that thing where you like go bungee jumping off of a bridge? I want to do that off of like the Newport Bridge. I don't think that you can though.
I want to do Spike's Junkyard Dog Challenge, 6 more dogs.
I'm from Wisconsin, so I'd like to visit a beach at some point.
I want to eat a quahog or quahog. How do you say it? I want to eat a quahog.
Quahog, yeah.
Quahog.
Have you tried coffee milk?
Coffee milk? Yes.
Have you tried like hot wieners?
Hot what?
Hot wieners.
Hot wieners.
Yeah.
No. I enjoy hot dogs, like, so.
Yeah, you would like these. They look like that. It's hot dogs, and then there's, like, meat with onions. You don't have to get onions on it, though.
All right.
So, yeah.
Hot wieners. What about sauerkraut?
That's not on that. I don't know if they have that. But that's not traditional. You got to go get hot wieners.
All right. They're delicious. I'll look out for some hot wieners.
There you go. So that's on his list. Joining us now to tell us more about the foodie bucket list and other articles in this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly is Associate Editor Jamie Coelho. Good morning.
Good morning.
A lot of interesting answers there.
Seriously, they need to get their hands on a copy of this issue right now because education.
Let's start there. Right off the bat, the cover is impressive, featuring a lot of different foods, some that you can specifically find just here in Rhode Island. Mm-hmm. So what was the concept behind this?
Well, it really came from years of research and dining at the best restaurants in the state, mm-hmm. and also including some of those iconic food items. So we had a team of freelancers, one from Newport, myself, and a few others, and we really went to all the restaurants and picked our favorite dishes that were the most memorable. Mm-hmm. Then we also did a little sidebar on food tours, so people can go experience a bunch of them within a tour.
Yeah, that's a great idea. And you break them down so nicely, too. You're providing a lot of information, not just what they are, but where they can be found.
Right. And then we also pulled some of the state's best food experts and asked them for, like, the best thing they ever ate in Rhode Island. So that's a really fun sidebar where people can get some good ideas.
Yeah, we don't want to give too much away because this is chock full
It's an education in food.
Awesome.
In Rhode Island. So.
It's a lot more than that, though, because you dive deeper into to many different stories, one of which I'm Sierra Barter.
Great.
She's part of the PVD Lady Project. She's been on our show many times.
Right. And Sierra is an amazing woman. So the Lady Project is a women's networking group, and they do a lot of charity work as well and just build each other up with mentoring and things like that. And it's really launched across the nation now. She has 9 different chapters and expanding into the spring and fall, too.
Great. So. Also something called Eastern Escapes.
Right. And you always see these beautiful homes in Newport. So we take you behind the scenes to see some Japanese Zen gardens.
Ooh.
So they have tea houses and koi ponds, and it's just like an escape to a different world, really.
Something beyond just the front of the house that we're used to driving by.
So gardens and things like that. So
we also know summer camp is coming up for a lot of kids, and you break that down as well.
Right, there's a guide so people can figure out which is the right fit for their child, and they can get all the information in one place. Which is fantastic.
Enterprising women as well in the back.
One.
This is full of everything.
Yeah, and then we also have the Best of Rhode Island coming up, too. And we just advertised that voting begins on our site through April 30th at rimonthly.com.
So and that's something, too, where there are so many different categories. So you can get on there and vote for a lot of your favorites.
Right. Restaurants, salons, health clubs. So it's all write-in answers. So you can go on and see the poll and make sure you nominate your very favorite business.
Yeah, and not just your favorite in the state, but in area, in a certain area
as well.
Yeah, we
break it down by towns and cities. And
awesome. You can even vote for your favorite morning show while you're there.
All
right, thanks, Jamie.
All right.
You can, of course, snag your own copy of Rhode Island Monthly. This month's edition is available for purchase in local shops now.